You, the city of Vala is like rather vast city, very densely populated, as you can see, with this gigantic kind of shimmering. Well, it kind of looks gold in the sun, but not really. But this golden, almost palace-like thing in the center of the city, and from that central point, like where it's like sparsely populated, that's where all the wealthier people live. And then it just as it gets further and further out, you get more into like slums and less ideal living conditions.
Go shooing into the crowd.
I'm trying to roll a crit so I can see what happens. There we go. Thank you. Sorry.
Mm-hmm. Putting screaming crowd sounds.
Oh god.
No. But yeah. At the gate, pretty much, there are representatives from the city guard, and you guys all arrive in a car. Basically, what happened was a car came for the one that was for whoever was furthest away. It came for you, and then it just came and picked up you guys along the way. It enters through the city gates, takes you down the main kind of street, the stretch, the straight, I mean, and you see all sorts of people here, I think you see like avian man walk by. There's like people with all sorts of different skin tones. Like you see a man with he kind of looks very fat and has green skin, and has these long kind of tendrils as like hair, essentially. There are all sorts of, if you can name it, it's probably here.
A man covered in shit.
There is a shit man walking by here.
A man eating his own head.
Yeah. Yeah, there's a man eating his own head there. There's crazy shit in here.
Fuck me.
Yeah.
Prison.
I'm all crazied out, guys. I've got to go to sleep.
A normal.
You're all crazied out.
Crazy.
Mm-hmm. There are all kinds of people here. And there's this car. It's got like blacked out windows, and you know, it's all official. And there is
the
a
Riftmaster in this town.
There is two people up front. One of them's driving, one of them's passenger, obviously. Where you're kind of just sitting in the back, and you kind of made the trip in a rather awkward silence, as you don't really know each other at all.
The only thing that you can hear is just the tapping of me just at a keyboard. Just I'm writing like a big fuck off mechanical keyboard.
along with that, you have the annoying click of me opening my Zippo and closing it, and then opening it and closing it, lighting a cigar, snuffing it out, opening it, closing it, lighting a cigar, just like.
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm just tapping away at the tablet.
Yeah.
I didn't actually bring.
Yeah.
Does
anyone say anything to each other as you? As you enter the city.
You can also probably hear my breathing, because I breathe really heavily.
Hey, are you a mouth breather? Is that it? I mean, we're all, like, pretty humanoid, right?
Yeah.
Except for the burn motherfucker. Oh!
Are you all human?
Sort of like the breathing from like...
I'm human.
The helmet from like...
metal-skinned man.
I'm an elf. But nobody can tell. Nobody can tell my gender either, so...
Do you look burned as fuck? As far as we know?
No, I don't look burned.
Oh, okay.
Here have you seen my character image?
No, I have not.
Are you, you were like...
It's in my journal. Yeah. That's what I look like.
Got the blue
hair.
Now here's the big question. Are you...
I look like this cat.
Are you terrestrials or extraterrestrials?
Since most of you are human. Cool.
Since most of you are human, you're probably terrestrials.
Yeah.
Are elves terrestrial?
Yeah.
I am terrestrial.
So you're all pretty much terrestrial. That's good.
Yeah.
It's good to know.
But Scott, who has the edgier character of me and you? We're both in all black.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh.
You've got
I mean, it's difficult.
The black
which one are you?
Rahes. I can't see the names because for some reason the little dot which tells you.
Nah, I'm not edgy. Trust me. When you start talking to me, you'll realize I'm 0% edgy.
The little dot which tells you who can see the thing is just hovering over the names for some reason. So I can't see what the names exactly are. But yeah.
My name is Romastas.
Mm-hmm.
I cock my guns, by the way. Like, or like, I make sure they are.
I'm sort of like guns.
I take the mag out, I check it, and then I put it back in, and sort of like cock it, and then put it back in my holsters. I look at the rest of the group.
Cock gun every 2 seconds. Like,
yeah, just like to make sure it's working.
So like the shotgun, you just go. Like, just inject the cartridge for no reason.
Yeah, but I checked the gun as soon as we entered the city, basically.
Hmm.
Just sort of sit there with my arms folded, just sort of looking down.
You do see a few like shadier types, you know.
Yeah.
As with every city.
I say so.
As soon as you say so, I say Zilla.
Warrior Princess.
Okay. I'm Drail. Anyone else? Hello?
Take a long drag of the cigar, and I just look at you and I say, my name is Augustus. Just
my name is Edgemaster 3000.
Edgemaster 3000.
Edgemaster.
So, Sam.
We're all edge. Too much edge.
I want to make a first roll of the game.
Yeah, sure.
I want to open up Google and search Agossus.
Okay.
O-S-S-U-S space.
Agossus.
Space.
Do I need to make an Arcana roll?
Yeah, sure.
There's my 25.
Oh.
Basically, I want to Google them all and find out as much information as I can to find.
You probably, like, drag up a few files of... I don't know. What have you been involved in any, like, major events in the past?
This is, like, collective, because I've been doing this for everyone.
Yeah.
Well.
Has anyone been involved in any events?
I was part of Spec Ops for a city.
I'm a...
You probably give
that. So Kieran isn't on that Google search.
The more I search for it.
Like I'm hidden behind like fire, like defenses. Like that's all my files are.
Defenses.
You probably file a few.
Yeah,
you probably find like
ex-military. That's it. Just...
Yeah, that,
yeah.
You probably find my basic soldier detail, stuff that they would actually give out.
Yeah.
But not anything to do with missions and shit like that.
Why not? I got a 25.
It's true.
You probably find a few that he was given a medal or something.
Okay.
Like minor.
The purple
minor
heart.
Stuff.
He got
yeah,
shot
the
once.
Purple heart. Yeah, he got shot once.
I shot once.
Just once.
That's it, just shot once.
Wasn't even like a full on blow, it just glanced.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Give those purple medals out for everybody. It's fine.
Mm-hmm. It is so true.
Anyone else? Any public information?
Stop your tour.
Or hidden information that I can find? I can find both.
Yeah.
I don't think you'd find any for me.
No medical records.
There's a record of me going in for grievous burn wounds that seem to no longer be on my body, but that's it.
Fun.
And, you know, you also
Does anyone have their own devices?
Devices?
Like phones?
Yeah, I mean, I'd have a phone.
Okay, do phones normally have a wireless connection in this universe, then?
Yeah.
Cool. I know your passwords.
Okay.
Spoilers, I can do that in real life, too.
Come get me! Come get my passwords!
I don't have a phone.
Fuck
on
that!
Me.
It's very nice.
I don't have a phone on me. My dog tags are electrical, I guess.
Electrical dog tags.
Not like electronic, like the bad.
Yeah.
Magic.
I probably wouldn't have much information about myself. Besides many different names.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you just hear a heavier breath. Almost like a sigh. Yeah.
Just an untouchable bitch.
So. That's three of us introducing ourselves. Anyone else? Big guy over there.
Yeah, James.
Hello?
Jamzu?
I think he's asleep.
Didn't he say that he was going somewhere?
Oh,
maybe.
I don't know.
How about you, helmet guy?
He's been tight. I just looked around, just look.
There's a man in a T-pose.
I start balancing things
character
on him.
Character mod hasn't been rendered. Oh, he can't talk.
Okay.
Yeah, sort of just turn around, just sort of. I prefer not to use names, I don't think they're that important. Just sort of turn back around me.
Well,
I Google his name.
My name is not important.
Come on, everyone's got to have
oh,
a name.
Oh, what you're about to do.
Otherwise, I'm just going to call you Helmet Guy.
Tell me what you wish.
I've changed his records to Helmet Guy.
If you must call me a name, you call me Romister.
Oh. Okay, Rome.
Romeo.
Or you can call me Rom if you want.
Nope. Romulus. I think I'll call you Rome. So.
I'm just read-only memory.
So,
Ha! Memory is RAM!
Mm-hmm. Wow.
Mm-hmm.
So, anyone Should been I to this city it? Before? You know. Come on. Anyone?
No. Really.
All you know is it was built around one of the Great Rifts, which is probably held within that gigantic golden building.
But would any of us probably have been here before? Like,
you might have been here before, yeah.
Yes, I've been here on business.
Huh. What do you know of, like, shady types, then? Is it more prominent in this city than any other?
Shade types or shady types?
Shady.
Shady types.
Oh, the shade type.
The shade type.
The shade type of human.
Oh.
Yeah.
Do you know where to look?
Yeah, I'd rather not look for them. I just want to know who to look out for.
Oh.
Meanwhile, while you're all talking, I'm just like, criminal network. Who fucking looks?
Well, I can help you out in that department.
Anyway, when are we getting to this guy that hired us? I'm a little tired.
Midday.
One of the people in the front.
Gotta get to sleep whenever you can.
They're both wearing like black suits. He says, it's just another 5 minutes from here.
All right. So, who wants to play I Spy? Anyone? No. Yeah.
Suddenly, Robustus just goes, "What? Who's a spy? I'm not a spy."
Sort of slightly like tips my head a little more, just. But...
No. Do you not know what I Spy is? I'll just stay quiet then.
To be honest, I had no idea what you said, like, in person, because I'm busy doing stream stuff, so I'm like, what? A spy? Who wants to play a spy? What?
So, like, 5 more minutes pass.
Traditionally, the game is played inside a car, though Ihao recommends airports, waiting rooms, and around the house, as objects can go by too quickly when moving around, parenting,
Google that.
I'm reading off the Wikipedia for I Spy.
What is that your character's
said.
Thing? To just Wikipedia,
I mean, what
everything?
You've made Google legitimate now, so I can do this.
Can actually Google things. Yeah. But yeah, so, like, you wait another 5 minutes and, the car eventually pulls up to a kind of large complex building that's kind of nearer towards the big dome in the center of the city, and it says on the front, like, you know, like, City of Valor Guard Barracks, you know. And, the guy in the front says, "Come on, there we go. Don't want to keep him waiting."
I sort of waiting. I'm like slowly,
And as he kind of waits for you to all get out and says, my, what an eclectic bunch.
A fancy rave.
Mm-hmm.
I just say nothing. Straighten my coat and start walking.
There's a guard, Captain.
Hmm?
Who said that?
That was the one of the guys who was driving you here.
Yeah, as you say that, I just say obviously he's not the guard captain.
Hmm.
Who is the guard captain then?
Guard captain.
Captain James Reynolds.
Captain James.
Captain James.
I don't even speak. I just like bring up a hologram that just says his name. Well, I can do that because I have minor illusion.
Nice.
That's why it's like holograms.
Holograms.
Pretty interesting. So, let's go meet him.
Yeah, right this way. And the two guys in suits lead you into the building. Inside, you're taken through a few corridors and into what looks like a kind of operations room. There's a large holographic projector in the center of the room with a kind of map of the whole city, and you see this kind of like red dots with like names on them.
Okay.
So, like, and you think they're, like, names of gangs or something. And they're standing over the hologram. There is a man dressed in kind of like a simple kind of uniform. And he says as you enter, welcome, gentlemen. Welcome. I trust you enjoyed your trip.
Very much.
It was all right. A little boring.
Proficient.
That's to be expected. What I called you here to do today was, is of quite some importance. We've been tracking the movements of a terrorist cell within the city.
What's their size? What's their objective?
They are anti-ET terrorists. Anti-extraterrestrial. They operate in the city, and they've been going into extraterrestrial bars and just killing everyone inside, shit like that. You know, I've got my men dealing with them, but there is one guy that managed to make it out of the city that we've been tracking for a while, and we think that he is their leader.
You know his name?
His name is Laris. He's an elf. That's what our intel suggests, but he's been known to change his shape, probably by magic.
I looked at Zilla as he says, you know, that he's an elf.
You can't tell that I'm an elf, by the way.
No, I know. I'm looking to you for information.
Okay.
Are you typing away on your keyboard, like, researching these
people? Yeah, I mean, as people talk, you will naturally get used to me just, like, looking up what they're saying. And then if there's, like, if they're talking about someone, I will bring up an image to, like, you know.
Yeah.
Okay.
Just a terrorist cell. You know, like in games when you're like talking and they're like the background has like images coming up. Like if you've ever played the Metal Gear games, like
the newest Batman.
It's exactly like that. Yeah.
So you called five of us here to get one guy.
Yeah. He's outside of the city limits, and that's where my problem is. I can't spare enough men to go out there for a manhunt. But we think he is taking shelter with a group of probably bandits. I don't know. Some guys living outside the city bounds, terrorizing anyone they come across.
And that's where we come in, I assume.
Yes.
Just sort of not concentrating.
I don't care for the bandit group, but if you can get this guy, then if you can bring him to me alive or dead, then I will reward you with quite the sum.
Say no more.
Is payment equivalent if he's dead and alive?
Yeah, it's the same no matter what.
Dead is more efficient, we should kill them.
So where are they?
We bring in this bandit camp as well. What do we get paid then? I mean, surely we're going to have to kill them anyways to get to him, but what?
Perhaps.
What do we get in return for having to kill all of them? Do we get more than just bringing in that one man?
I'd give you extra pay, yeah.
What is the pay you are offering just for the man?
About 500.
A piece?
500 monies?
500 monies, yeah.
Each.
Dollar,
I'd say more than that. I'd say about 1,000 each.
Oh, he's pretty high profile then. For you guys, at least.
This guy's high profile. I mean, he's the leader of, this guy's responsible for the murder of countless ETs.
Hey, I, take out a cigar. Hey. And before I light it, I ask...
Just imagining E.T. His signature line, he goes into a bar and just says, E.T., go home. Shoots everyone.
I take out a cigar and I just say, can I light this in here? Do you mind?
Yeah,
my character's
sure,
going to have horrible lung cancer by the end of this campaign, by the way. and
welcome,
welcome
to Richard Blackley.
I just take a long drag and I say, alright, I'm in, that's for sure. Couldn't use the money. What do you know about these bandits? Where they're at?
Where they are, yeah.
Who they are, if they worship any god.
They use cars to get around. Whereas the,
Did you see an image of a car appearing?
Yeah.
They use cars to get around.
Yeah.
What can you tell me about the deeper stuff?
What type of cars? Are they modded in any way?
Probably. I don't know. I heard they attach weapons to them sometimes.
Do they witness me in suicidal acts?
Yeah, probably.
Witness me!
You don't really need to know how they travel. You just need to know where their base is.
Yeah. That's true.
But that's how they get their advantage over the townspeople.
That's always good to know.
They don't have cars out there. There's barely anyone living out there that's not one of them. But those who are don't have cars.
So are you willing to lend us a car for the time being so they don't have this advantage?
Yeah.
Could you give a rough description of what they look like?
Band colors or...
I've heard they use... They have, in terms of armament, they have guns and all sorts of crap. Their identifying mark is the Black X on each of their cars.
Black X, easy enough.
Mm-hmm.
Sky's kick, here I come.
I'm confused now. They drive cars, but where's their base? Like, that's the only thing I want to know. I don't really care about the cars.
Just
with them, whatever.
I don't know where their base is. You'd have to find that out for yourself.
I mean, they're close enough to a town to be raiding it ever so often. We start at the town, we find our way out, and we're good.
Right. So, I'll hit you up with a car. Something useful for the terrain. It's pretty rocky and sandy out around where the rift opened.
Okay.
So I'll get you something for. Useful in the terrain.
Sounds good.
Who can drive? I mean, I can, but I don't particularly want to.
What's the driving skill based off of? Dex? Int? Wiz?
Yeah, Dex.
I can drive.
Isn't it just a proficiency?
I'm proficient in vehicle.
It would be, yeah, it would be
Dex and then proficiency.
I don't have proficiency with driving. I should really get it though. I guess that won't matter because I get it with my vehicle.
Wait, where is the proficiency in driving?
It's just land vehicles.
Yeah, land vehicles.
It's the same as horses. If you're proficient in driving a car, you are also proficient in driving a horse.
Mm-hmm.
And a tank.
I don't think I have the skill.
And a metal gear.
Metal gear. No mechs, Scott. No geckos.
Please mechs. I want to just do a big boss impression the whole time.
Where's the skills
for land vehicles? Do you add it in like a custom skill or whatever? There's no like.
It's in. You put it in tools. Probably in background.
Alright.
Yeah, I got it from my soldier background. So I'm proficient with a gaming
set.
Yeah,
I wish you gentlemen good luck.
I think that one's a girl.
And hopefully you can bag this guy.
Don't say anything.
Everyone ignores it. It's just.
What? Get what?
Shouldn't be too hard. He's fleeing, he's scared.
Mm-hmm.
Just one more question. How much of his group have you gotten inside the city? All of it? 90%?
We're not currently sure. I mean,
how many in total do you have locked up?
In total?
Well, locked up and buried, I should say.
Probably about 20 men. So there's most likely more of them still up in the city. And God knows how many of them there could be.
Oh, well, that's what's been more, I suppose.
I turn around to the group. I say, so who wants to go to an extraterrestrial bar tonight?
Are we even allowed
to? Animals.
Extraterrestrial bars within 1 mile.
Yeah. Hey, okay.
Is that like the equivalent of a gay bar? Like,
yeah. This one's equivalent to a gay bar. Gays and ETs. Yeah.
What is this guy's name? What's this guy's name?
What's your dad's name?
You know, I think me and Scott will be able to get in easy because we. Well, in fact, does Aaron not wear a mask as well? Yeah. All of us wear masks. So
I just pull off my mask and then shove it on my face and they'll be like, okay, you're an ET.
Mm-hmm.
I mean.
Are you not?
We're all the terrestrials.
That's what you like, Scott. You like fucking.
I'm an elf.
Deadpool.
But I don't fucking look like an elf.
You like techie Deadpool. That's what you.
I don't have a face.
Much more intelligent Deadpool.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's not gone mad.
Yeah.
I don't think Wade was very smart to begin with.
What was this guy's name?
James Reynolds.
James what?
Reynolds.
I'll say that. Yeah. I thought you meant the bandit leader, yeah.
No.
He's called Jim.
And the town name is, Erstad. Fatten. Fatten.
It's called Fatten.
Fatten, yeah.
Fatten?
Fatten.
With the PH, I hope.
Fatten, yeah.
While we're going to the gay bar, I make a suggestion.
Gay bar.
You're going to a gay bar?
No, we're off to the ET bar.
While we're heading to the ET bar, I make a suggestion.
Go ahead.
So rather than going in guns blazing, why don't we go to wherever they are staying and blend in with them?
That was the point of going to the ET bar. If they start any trouble, we keep one alive. with him being alive, we can get information.
I don't understand. How would going to an ET bar make us fit in with anti-ET?
They attack him, don't they? I mean, I'm sure...
Yeah, so
James
surely we
here.
Should get outside of the ET bar and wait for them attack. If they come in and they see us, sat around an ET bar, and then suddenly we stand up and pretend to be part of them...
I don't think you realize what I'm saying. I'm saying if they show up to the ET bar, we kill them, except for one. And then that
oh,
one,
no,
we
that's
get information
not what
from.
I mean. We blend in with them. Trust me. We arrange talks with this leader, man.
I mean, James, do you know where the leader, or where one of their hangouts is? You can go and, you know, search.
Well, James isn't there anymore. Left James.
Oh, we left James? Okay.
The problem
well,
is we don't know
I
where
I call him Reynolds just because there's James in in the game as a player.
Yeah. The thing is, Zyla, well, we don't know where they are.
I just put my fucking hands in my hands. Dude.
Zyla.
What? It's true.
Are you talking about the town that they're attacking?
If we blend in with them, then we can find out where they are. That's what I'm saying.
We
need to do is find a car and then write the giant fucking X on it.
Well, we also need to find them. You know, like inside
oh,
the city.
We know where they are.
So blend in with the bandits, okay,
you know,
okay.
Yes, that's what I'm saying. Blend in with the bandits, not with.
I got
Listen,
you,
I was
I got
confused.
You.
I thought you meant the anti-ET, and I'm
oh,
like, no.
Why would we blend in with the targets to meet the leader? Come on,
not that crazy of an idea.
But yeah,
people I'm working with.
Hey!
Look.
I don't...
Holy fucking shit. Infallible relay. The material component is a mobile phone.
Yes. That's brilliant.
So, just to make sure there's no more confusion, get a car. You paint an X on it. We drive to that town and blend in.
Whatever the fuck they are.
James was hitting you up with a car anyway, so you could just paint an X on that.
Yeah, exactly.
Can we do it before we get out of town? Just in case they shoot at us, you know? I mean,
well,
after...
just the bar and, like, you know.
Yeah.
Being invited to join a Counter-Strike game.
Okay. Good.
What? Does Counter-Strike exist in this world?
You just play it on your tablet, you know.
Holy shit, that would be hard.
Mm-hmm. It
spraying, I've got to hold down my...
Like, seriously, if we can arrange some sort of conversation with this dude, I have the best fucking spell ever. Even if it's by mobile phone. the best fucking spell ever. You bring... With this spell, you can target any creature with whom you have spoken previously, as long as the two of you are on the same plane of existence. When you cast the spell... The nearest functioning telephone or similar communication device within 100 feet of the target begins to ring. If there is no suitable device close enough to this target, the spell fails. The target must make a successful charisma saving throw or be compelled to answer the call.
So it's the ultimate stalker spell.
Yeah.
With what?
That's brilliant. So, like, a phone...
If you've spoken to someone, you can ring them up. Like, calls a phone nearby them to just start ringing. You know, like in films where, like, people are walking down the street and then, like, the telephone box starts ringing. It's that. That's the spell.
Oh, wow. You have, like, the, kind of, like, phone call.
Yeah. It's fucking great.
An order for, plot progression.
You're paying a giant cross.
Well, you see, I just happened to know that this phone was right beside you.
I walk to Uthal. I say, hey, big fella. You know, I know you're not a car or anything, but if we paint a big X on you, that might work as well.
What?
This is a giant metal monster. If we paint a giant X on the giant shiny metal monster to also signify we're part of the gang.
I think it's gotta be a curse.
I mean, we have to look like normies, right? We have to look like normies.
Except
generally, yeah.
Yeah.
But elves are normies in this, you know?
I don't know if I look like a normie with glowing orange eyes, but yeah.
You gotta be at least terrestrial.
I mean, I look human.
Yeah. You look human.
Yeah.
So what are you doing?
I go to
an ET bar.
Yeah, I go to an ET bar and see if shit happens. If shit goes down.
Okay. So you go to the nearest bar. And, it's called, I'm trying to think of an ET pun. ET. Drink alcohol. E.T. drink alcohol.
Fuck's sake.
What?
Yep.
The extra tavern.
The extra tavern, yeah. But yeah, so you go to this bar, and,
we get denied entry because we're not E.T.
You don't get denied entry, but it's a main...
To be gay, to go into a gay bar.
Yeah, exactly.
Plus,
you're not denied entry
to a gay bar. We're wearing masks.
I'm not masked.
It's just everyone in the tavern will think you're gay.
Yeah, we're all extraterrestrials if we're in here, I guess.
Yep.
That's how it works.
We're all extraterrestrials tonight. We'll be whatever they want.
You're just human-like ones. You know.
We are the Vendaluvian Empire.
Elk insanely human like then.
Mm-hmm.
I haven't been modified like these other chumps.
But yeah, you get a drink and sit down. But how long are you waiting?
Oh, I just grab a drink and sit until the car arrives. Or are we told it was going to arrive tomorrow because all we got was a car will get to you.
No, he said he'll get one pretty soon, so...
Okay. Yeah, no, I just wait until the car arrives.
So you wait, like, about an hour.
Yeah.
Nothing much really happens. There's not many people in at this point, seeing as it's in the day.
By the way, are we carrying all of our weapons right now? Like, on
Probably.
Us? Okay, cool.
You get a few, like... odd looks, but it passes uneventfully, pretty much. And then you hear like a beep beep from outside.
I just end up saying, "Well, that'll be us, Jen." And I leave like a tip on the table. And fucking piece
of.
Alright.
Give him a dollar.
A dollar.
A pound. I don't know.
I leave them a monies.
A credit.
I leave them a credit.
That's the sci-fi currency, isn't it?
What's a credit token look like, Sam?
It looks like a small spherical bit of plastic, but when you try and break it, it's completely unbreakable.
So could I use it to block bullets?
Almost unbreakable. No.
Oh, I was just about to say, I could make credit armor.
That'd be
completely
the best
indestructible.
Indestructible.
Bullets, just not even hurting me.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, you leave him a credit. And,
I mean, I leave him, like, 5. Because we get whatever plus... Well, I have a lot of starting money anyway, so it doesn't matter.
And you see outside, there's, like... they've got basically a 4x4 parked outside.
I wonder if it's stick.
Hmm?
Nah, it's a stick shift.
Mm-hmm.
Of course it is.
Yep, it's
mm-hmm.
that.
It's that.
Yep. It's that. It's that. That's a car thing.
That's a car thing, yeah.
Yep.
Whatever that is, it's that.
Stick.
Yep. Bye-bye.
It's not an automatic.
Is it like an SUV? Or like...
It's... Yeah, it's like an SUV kind of type thing. And you see they've...
7-seat, 8-seat?
It's like 4-seat, so you could probably...
5-seater.
Yeah,
just so
you could probably fit the Goliath in the back.
In the boot.
In the boot, yeah.
Or it's like a pickup truck.
No, it's not a pickup truck, it's a... It's like a... I'd say it's like a Land Rover type thing.
I say it, right.
Five seats, yeah.
Whoever's driving, take us
Ford
to a...
Fiesta.
Someone take us to a, paint shop. We got some paint to do.
Thought you were driving.
Suddenly there's a montage of us painting the car. It's just a really slow montage of us just painting an X on it.
Yeah.
Just like...
From like different angles.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. We need a motto.
And then if you're painting an X on the giant metal man.
Yeah.
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 Freeze frame while we're all jumping.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Fist in the air.
Jumps internally.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but you take him to like you take it to like a back alley.
No, I was just wanting spray paint.
Yeah.
Done.
Yeah, you just spray paint.
Me.
No!
Me.
No chrome paint!
Yes, chrome paint. Always chrome paint.
Always.
You see my character pick up an extra, like, can of chrome paint, throw it away. Just for later.
That's part of the montage.
Yeah.
Yeah, you paint the car. And, head on out, I guess. And that is the point where we play some music. You turn on the radio.
Because it's actually.
And you hear a familiar sound.
I love this song.
My character just breaks out in the full rendition. He's fucking singing his heart out.
Driving.
No. Not me.
Nobody's driving.
Nobody's driving now. You're all jamming.
I'm driving. Fine, I'll drive.
Put your lungs in the
I don't have the lion skill, so.
I mean, you don't need it to drive.
No, but if shit goes down.
Well, I have a +6 in it then.
There's a wide shot of the car just. Sailing along the sand.
Mm-hmm. You just like change the picture as if it's like a film, like.
Yep. I was soaring ever higher. And I flew too high. But yeah. And get some music on, and Scott, you set the GPS.
It's just a fucking straight line, because we're on just like one of those desert roads.
Yeah, pretty much.
I'm like tapping the steering wheel to this song.
Yep. and you kind of see these wide dunes to either side of you, dotted with like dotted rocks every now and again, with these mountains like quite far in the distance, and you can see a few like buildings like scattered around in a few places. But yeah, you just ride it out. But yeah, you, and within an hour or two, you're probably at the town. But like, as you're within about a mile or so of the town, you start to actually make perception checks.
My passive perception is 14, that is 16.
16?
Yeah. Okay, fucked, Sam.
Woo!
Shit, I was gonna actually roll normally.
Okay.
25.
Yeah, you see Remestus and Drail. You both see behind you a sizable cloud of dust. Drail, as you look in the mirror, you can probably tell that there's two cars closing in from behind you.
Okay. I relay this information. There's two cars coming towards us. Can I see if they've got the exit on the front? They probably do.
They're a bit far away.
I did get told that they're the only ones that really have the cars.
I flip around in my seat. Seatbelt not on, of course, right? Look behind us and just fucking roll my window down and just start throwing out devil horns and rocking out. Of course.
I just sort of like make sure my weapons are like fully loaded.
I hacked the car.
I hacked the car. Yep.
That's a thing you can do in Shadowrun. So.
It is.
You don't have the car. I'm driving it right now.
Not our car, you idiot. Their car.
You said the car. I don't know which car.
Too far away to hack.
I'm not gonna hack the car. I can't hack a car, right?
You can hack cars nowadays.
Maybe this.
Can't stop.
Are they within 60 feet though? That's the question.
No, but I can wait.
I mean, you could actually do that. That would be great.
Yeah. No, because it's not an electronical device, unless I'm riding an electric car.
Well, I mean, cars are electric by nature.
They're in hybrids.
No, cars turn off the engine.
Yeah, cars, like, literally the reason the engine is running is to power the battery, right? So,
yeah.
It turns wheels and all that shit.
Oh! Wait 6 seconds. Over car off.
In the meantime, rocking out.
Mm-hmm.
Trying to fit in with these bandits.
These guys are faster than us, right? Are they, like...
They seem to be coming at quite a pace, yeah. Are you just,
I'm just driving normally.
Yeah, you're just driving normally,
already
so...
flooring it. That would
they're
be
pretty much,
irresponsible.
They're pretty much flooring it. Mm-hmm.
Dangerous. I don't want to turn. I don't want to flip the car.
I'm just gonna be watching them and see like when they. I mean, I'm still rocking out devil horns out the window. I'm assuming other songs are playing worthy of rocking.
Keeping a watch another. I was
trying to put Danger Zone on, but
Danger Zone.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Danger Zone.
But yeah, these cars are closing quite fast.
Yeah.
This one.
Well, I know my guns are fine.
I mean, if we're gonna start looking at high level spells, I could literally turn off the car. If they're within 120 feet.
Yeah.
You can use any electronic device within range as if it were in your hands. This is not a telekinesis effect. Rather, the spell allows you to simulate a device's mechanical functions electronically. You are able to access only functions that a person using the device manually will be able to access.
You could literally flip their car.
Yeah, I could just be like...
crash
the car.
I looked at Zo and I say, let's try and fit in.
But that's a level one spell, so that's gonna cost me.
I just looked at Zo and say, maybe we should wait first, try that fitting in thing you wanted to do.
Yeah.
But, keep that close by. I'm not sure, I'm too good at shooting out of cars.
Hey, don't worry, I could do that too. Not while driving, though.
But yeah, they close in quite close, and you can see they do have the they do look to have the black X's on the bonnets.
Now, as they get closer, are they hanging out windows and flipping shit, or are they just driving like normal people?
They're hanging out windows and flipping shit.
I join them. I start hanging out the window and fucking acting the part.
Yeah, they're holding the fucking guns out the window.
Yeah,
just going, woo!
Yeah, it is the same. Fucking AA 12 up.
Accidentally shoot one in the face! Oh no!
No, I hold my AA 12 up in the air and I start screaming and shouting to Gula over Karen and just fucking like fire off a couple rounds into the air. Just, being with my bros.
And eventually they get pretty close to you. Like, within 60 feet.
Then they tell you to stop being so disrespectful to the environment.
And they look to be kind of like trying to pull alongside you.
Okay, I let them. I'm in control of the vehicle.
Is it just me or it sounds like... Oh, no, okay, it's fine.
Yeah, our light went off there for a second.
Yeah.
I don't know what it does. I don't know what it's doing. It's weird.
It's Scott. He's using
Scott's
level
in the machine.
Scott is in the machine.
What do you think I'm typing, guys?
No, Scott's in the machine. He's
typing in the hack codes.
The hack codes.
Because that's how hacking
hack
works.
That is how you hack. Yep.
Type in hack codes.
Definitely don't just
type
run a pro.
Nope.
But yeah, they pull alongside you and you're a woman, yes? No, you're not a woman.
No, I'm not.
I thought you were.
I don't think any of us are women.
Okay.
Wait,
we have four men and an androgynous.
One guy just leans out and
I mean that's a girl booty though in your character. That's that booty though.
As far as we know. That could be a dude.
It's a man
dude.
Dude got a nice booty, though.
Well, I mean, you're attracted to a man booty, so what does that say about you?
Oh.
That man booty is pretty goddamn fine. What that says.
Uh-huh. But yeah, one of the guys leans out, and he sees the X that you've painted, and he's just going to make a quick... He's just gonna make a quick look, to see if he's intelligent enough to notice that you're not in his gang.
I mean,
attire aside,
I'm pretty sure we don't fit in, except for me, because I'm hanging out a window and acting all crazy.
I'm driving. I'm not gonna hang out the window.
Ghost ride this whip, motherfucker.
I'm gonna be Eris.
No,
just start ghost not. Riding.
He's just like leaning out and going woo, and he tries to high five you.
Dude, I high five him so hard.
as he high five.
High five him so far. He like falls out of the car.
Okay, I don't hold that.
Everyone dies. No,
and then as they kind of speed past you, he says, "What are you doing? We're trying to get back."
Trying
to get what?
What?
What did he say? He's trying to get what? Back.
Hey, are you okay there?
He said,
no. Yeah.
To get back.
Are you good? The dust back. Seems to be making your voice crack a little bit, and I'm like,
speed up, okay,
speed up.
I floor it.
The man says, American? Speed up.
Was that like?
Was that
American
redneck.
Lyric there?
Redneck.
My voice.
Sam, was that? Was that American Rurik there?
Yeah.
I floor the
Rurik.
I floor the fucking SUV.
Yeah.
All right. You keep pace with them. Pretty much. And, and your car's kind of like, you get to where, to the town in no time, pretty much. You see this town is, what wants to look to be like, it looks to be like what was once a mining town. There's a big kind of like structure leading into like what looks like a mine that burrows into one of these into a big kind of rock, and it's a fairly small place, and there's only a few. Buildings and like a few of them are even like ruined. But you see two other cars just parked here, and a bunch of guys sitting around a fire in the center of the town. They're in kind of mishmash armor, pretty much. Some of them have like, some of them have decent like Kevlar, but some of them are just like unarmored.
So not really compared to us, good armored or like, how well will we fit in with what we're wearing? Is what I'm asking.
You'll fit in decently well.
They can't see my armor. My armor is like all underneath my shit, clothes.
I'm wearing my armor open. I can't not.
I'm wearing my zero armor very open. My no armor whatsoever.
But I pop back in and I say, so what's the plan if there's some, people up here need our help? Motherfucking bandits start making trouble. Do we kill all of them, keep one alive, and torture them, or what? Or do we join them and, kill some of these citizens up here and gain their trust.
So we go along with it. You don't have to kill anybody.
If I know these people, and I think I do, these motherfuckers can try and kill some people. That's it. If there is any people left up here.
Listen, just try to fit in. Don't try to cause any trouble.
I'm sorry, I'm the one hanging out the window half the time down here. All you guys are just sitting in here being bored.
Because now we're driving the car.
Ghost ride this motherfucker.
You try to ghost ride this in fucking 80 miles per hour.
Ghost
ride!
No, you ghost ride it and you climb onto the roof. Which is what I do. Then I climb out onto the roof from my seat.
Well, he's on the roof.
But yeah, from here you can see there's about probably about 8 of them.
And with the people in the cars near us, that makes
about 16 in total.
Well, drive until we stop near them, I guess.
But yeah.
Stop abruptly, and then Cam goes flying off the roof.
I've got a good hold. Got a good hold.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, the two of the cars pull up, and they get out, and you can hear them chatting amongst us and amongst themselves, and they're just like, they're saying, like, aren't they the bunch from out west? And then another one says, I suppose so.
Well, are they all like perfectly coordinated, and they're like, we just all step out, but just stop.
Mm-hmm.
Sup, man.
I hop off the roof.
But we're the elite splinter cell that doesn't have uniform.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm not with the uniform.
We are from the west.
Ah, cool.
What are y'all doing here? We didn't get much information before we were told to come here, so.
We just chilling here for now. Before the real fun begins.
What are you guys called?
Yeah. Got ourselves a town out to the east. Heavily populated, so we need all the men we can get.
Well, it's a good thing we showed up then.
Yeah, it is.
Why don't we play a little bit?
Would it look weird if I just stayed in the car while these guys had come out?
Maybe. I'm not sure.
Okay. Well, I would just stay in the car until someone said get out of the car.
Would we know if you had, like, a gender or whatever?
No.
So.
Got that booty, though. That's all we know.
You can look at my ass if you want, but, you know, it could be gay. Could not be. You don't know.
Hey, booty's a booty.
I thought she got a girl.
You can probably get some new recruits out there, if you know what I mean.
Whipping them into submission.
Why don't we fail? Yeah. Are we all like out of the car now, except for
yeah. And he says, what's his problem?
Him?
Not too much of a people.
Yeah, out west, we have to do things a little bit different. We got smart folk out there. He's the one that deals with all their smart inventions. He doesn't like talking to
people more than computers.
Interesting.
Now, tell me, my friend. You got a drink around here? Let's celebrate.
Damn right we have.
Goddamn right, I figure so. Celebrate before we get on to this fun.
And then you hear one of the bandits say, bitch, get out here! And then you see a...
The old day medieval bar wench.
You see a woman dressed in kind of like pretty much rags, she just like comes out, and one of them says, why don't you go and fix yourself some drinks, darling? She kind of like rolls her eyes and goes back inside.
Bitch, get out of here and I'll go make us some drinks. She's like,
the sort of bandit. Like, we're sort of talking to it. I like grab him by the shoulder and like sort of pull him close a bit. Just like, why don't we play a little game when we get out there?
What's that?
What's that?
Biggest body bag win.
I'm not casting these, by the way, I'm just testing.
Yeah. What did you say?
Biggest body bag wins.
You're all.
Wait, so just look for fat people?
Look for fat.
I just mean like biggest, largest kill count.
Do you say that loud enough that everyone can hear it? Or, like, at least me?
No, I just sort of keep it quiet because I don't tell you guys that I'm a contract killer.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay. Sort of try to hide that as best as possible. For the moment.
I look. What type of cars do they have? Like, pretty similar to ours? Different than ours?
Generally.
Do they have General Lee?
Old Duke.
They probably have
again.
Cars. Probably like.
Chevys.
Yeah, like muscle cars and shit. Generally, anything that they can get their hands on. There's a Volvo among them.
Specifically a Volvo.
Specifically a Volvo, yeah.
They're all just general cars, except from the Volvo.
Yeah.
They're all like really low poly like cars, and then they're just the Volvo that's in perfect texture.
Perfectly clean.
Just the fucking graphic designer really liked Volvos.
It was modeled after his own car, but I look around and I try and see if there's any like guns on there, mounted or whatever.
One of them's got a like basically a heavy machine gun just strapped to the
like,
back.
Strapped as in duct tape or
as in like. Makeshift
mounted.
Pretty much duct tape.
It's about 20 layers of duct tape on it, just holding it together.
You said a heavy machine gun?
Yeah.
Shit! Is that what I think it is? And start walking over.
It sure is!
Oh man, you gotta show me this shit.
50 caliber?
Oh, a little sound of that.
Oh, Lord.
But that's accurate up to a mile.
Yeah, probably.
Y'all get to use it?
Nah, not really. Bullets are expensive.
Yeah, I'll make you a bet. I'll make you a bet.
All right.
First man to blackout drinking loses. Winner gets this nice piece of machinery right here. Loser, you get my prized possession. Get me real safe. And I like lift
your
up the prize A12.
Position?
Oh, yeah. Clear out a bar in 2 seconds flat.
That is. You are on, my friend. You are on.
Well, we're just like all challenging these rednecks to bets.
Oh, hell yeah.
Yep.
I don't think you realize. I'm going to get me a heavy machine gun.
And then we'll quickly strap it to our car.
No, I give it to the giant metal man.
Oh, yeah.
No one as good as me. A drinking.
You're drinking? We'll see.
Get ready to be drinked under the table.
Oh, I didn't get paladin spells. I'm so good at this game.
Get ready to be drinked under the table.
Do I just get, like, the stuff from my thing, or do I get actual paladin spells? I'm smart.
Yeah, you get actual paladin spells as well.
Okay.
Yeah, you will because you're level.
Charisma
plus, you have an elf now.
Charisma plus half your level paladin spells.
So what, like rounded up or down? For half the level?
It's rounded up.
Up, so
up.
I have
it'll be two.
Six spells, plots, question mark?
Six spells. Is that right?
Okay.
It's half paladin level plus charisma, so...
Yeah, I have 18 careers, which means 4, so it's 6.
Yeah. Yes!
That's just first level, right? That's just first level, right?
Yeah. Alright. So you challenge this guy to a drinking competition?
Yeah. And I purify food and drink all my stuff, quietly.
Yeah, once the woman comes out with the drinks, like the woman who was talking to before, just like slaps her because like, he's just like, "You didn't bring him out fast enough." You know.
Yeah, I purify food and drink on my side of the table only.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I do.
You purify food and drink.
Yeah.
That's actually quite useful.
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
But yeah, the drink's fine, you know, it's just average beer, pretty much.
Well, for you it tastes awful, because it's like non-alcoholic beer.
That's why. Mm-hmm. I'm about to get me a heavy machine gun. It tastes like victories. What it tastes like?
So, you can pretty much drink this guy under the table.
Yeah, no, I go until he's out.
It's non-alcoholic.
Bends the rules. So, yeah, I do that. I start acting like drunk a bit.
You get a bunch of beers and then you just purify them all.
Yeah, I only purify like half of them, so I do get a buzz and like slightly tipsy.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, that's just to keep up the ruse.
Yeah, so you don't even need to make a constitution or anything, because that's pretty good use of a spell that's not really used that much. You drink him under the table and like, pretty much one of his friends just like says, "I'm gonna be so sad to see that machine gun go."
Yes, I'll take good care of it. Don't you worry.
You sure are the best drinker I've ever seen.
And it takes years and years, my friend. Years and years. And I just go and I start cutting the duct tape off and I like just start taking the machine gun. I'm just like, nope, fuck this shit.
Yeah. Meanwhile, what's Scott? Are you doing anything in particular in the car?
I'm
he is sleeping.
My tablet, choosing my spells.
He is sleeping, apparently.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Sorry, I'm picking spells because I'm deciding in time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have a lot on stake.
Yeah.
Oh my God! Divine favor.
Anyone else doing anything else?
Not really.
Just chilling.
Chilling, nice and relaxing, all cool.
Mm-hmm.
Shooting some people outside of school.
Outside of the school.
A couple of fakes were up to no good.
Mm-hmm.
Started making trouble in my neighborhood.
Yeah.
Made one little bet and my mom got scared.
Make this man under the table.
Bel-Air.
just add Bel Air onto the end of the sentence. No one else is.
You said I get 6 spells? Jesus.
Yep.
Dude, I have 10. I have work to do.
Too many spells. Too many spells.
Too many spells. Too many spells.
Bel Air.
Too many spells, too many spells. In Bel Air.
Too many spells, too many, many spells. I have no fucking damaging spells except for the chromatic orb, by the way.
Nice.
Oh my God. I built the shittest fucking wizard.
That's fine.
No, you're gonna be the hacksaw, the elite hacksaw.
Elite hacksaw.
Yeah, I go back up to the sort of guy that I bet.
Yeah.
Sort of large cooker, and I sort of say, I'm just like, so, what sort of stuff are we up against?
Yeah. Just a, I don't know what accent that is. Just a, bunch of civilians and a few combat trained men, but they should be no problem.
Sounds like you picking.
Depends if the civilians have rifles or not. Small arms.
Sounds easy enough anyway.
What did you say?
It sounds easy enough anyway.
Yeah, should be.
Hey. Hey, you guys.
Yeah.
Where do you guys refuel normally? Like your base.
Refuel?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Usually further north towards the mountains, there's a small... We got a small hideout up there.
I mean, you know, we use quite a lot to get up here.
I mean, yeah, we can take you there if you want.
Sure, that'd be great.
There's a few... should be some gas in... there might be some gas in the station over there, and he points to a small, like, petrol station. That's just looks like it's been unused for a while.
Yeah.
I think there's some, still a bit left.
Oh my god, I have to add a pinch.
Alright, I'll probably go get some.
I mean, if you need more, you can always come up north with us. I mean, we're gonna have to go see the boss at some stage.
Well, sure, yeah, well, sure, I'd prefer that.
Alright then. Let's move out north then, boys.
Let's go. Get your man up off the ground.
And they begrudgingly kind of all get up, and one of them goes into the house, where the woman was, and pretty much just drags her out, and throws her in the back of one of their SUVs. And they basically lead you up north. Up north.
I now have a big Bertha.
Yeah, you can put it wherever on the...
Question, with my strength of plus 2, aka 15, can I wield this thing?
You won't be able to hip fire it.
I mean, I can't shoulder mount it either because it doesn't have a shoulder mount. So.
We could turn the car into Metal Gear.
Mm-hmm. Metal Gear.
You could probably, like, if you open one of the windows, you could probably stabilize it on the window.
Oh, okay. That's good enough for me.
But it would be, you wouldn't add to your proficiency bonus.
We're all in the car, right? We're all in the same car.
Yeah.
Yes.
I say to them, well, at least we're going to head find out where their base is now. The only problem is we don't know what that guy looks like.
Good.
You do, he had a hologram of him.
Well, yeah. That's true, yeah. But he did say he changes his appearance.
Oh yeah, he's a shapeshifter.
Oh, yeah. That's fine, I can detect where it is.
Fair enough. Mm-hmm.
I have ways.
Also, guys,
I have a lot of ways, let's just say that.
Mm-hmm.
I have multiple options.
Yeah?
Once we're inside the base, don't try to start any trouble. I mean, we're going to be inside enemy territory.
Oh, we have plenty of games, right?
I don't think I'll need to start any trouble. Got Big Bertha here. I'm pleased.
Wait, so is that your character accent, or are you just doing that because...
No, that's my character accent. It's slowly gotten more and more southern as we've gone on.
And please.
Because I've decided that's where it's going to be.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm following them. I want to the mountains. My favorite terrain.
Mm-hmm.
My favorite.
Your favorite.
Yeah.
Okay, so you follow a long desert road. And it probably takes you about an hour or two to get up there. You pass a few settlements. Some of them have inhabited, and some of the bandits give waves to some of the people living there. You presume they might be pretty much allied with them or something. The road starts to get more kind of more of an incline, and you see in the distance a cluster of quite a few houses, bigger than the village you were at, not like a city or anything. It's pretty much a large town by the looks of it. So you guys approach, and you see there are two more cars pulled up, and there's about four or five guys just sitting around there. On the kind of like fringe of the town. And you can see this seems to be another mining town. Is that like the northern end of the town is basically a rock face, and it's been they've obviously made a mine there. Built to mine.
As we get up close, if we're stopping, any of them, I just say, "What's y'all mine here?"
As you're stopping, or
mm-hmm. Like, I mean, if we're stopping near them, I don't know if this is like the main place that we're going or not.
If you stop near the bandits, or on the road.
That's up to Kieran for yourself.
Oh, where?
Or are we not stopping near this other mining town?
Are the bandits stopping?
The bandit cars that you're following are going, seem to be going past these bandits on the side of the road.
And yeah,
never mind. Yeah, I just walked right past them.
Okay.
I'm still following because I've controlled the car.
Okay, so you follow them into the town, and they pull up in like the center of town, pretty much.
Okay.
And there's quite a few buildings around here. Some of them, and you see like as you kind of drive up, you see a few of them. You see movement coming from in one of the buildings, some of them like shutting curtains. But the other bandits get out, and the ones that you're following, and they say, Kieran, gas is just down there if you need it.
Alright, so, hey, you guys, you get out, I'll go fill up the car.
Alright.
Okay. We're going to see the boss and then probably head out and raid this place.
Alright.
Sounds good.
So I drive down, I guess, and I fill up the gas, and then after I've done that, I go scout the town.
Okay.
Boom. That's what I'm doing.
So yeah, make a perception.
All of us.
Just Kieran, because he's scouting around, having a quick scout around the town.
Six, I think. Roll 17.
Okay, so you have a quick look around. You notice that there are quite a few people around. Like, you, when you're looking around, you stumble upon a little kid down an alley, and he kind of like, when you turn to look at him, he kind of like ducks behind into one of these buildings. You kind of like, you overhear some of the bandits talking, and they say, so why are we hosting some fancy pants from the city? And then another one says, I don't know, don't ask me. He got in some trouble with the cops or something. And you hear a few bits like that.
Yeah. Do I get like an appearance out of it?
Hmm?
Do I get like an appearance out of it? Do they say what he looks like? At all? I'll just...
No.
Okay.
Oh, and by the way, he has... They just describe exactly how he looks.
Well, no, because they might say something that, like... Oh, his features or something.
Fancy pants! There you go. He's got fancy pants.
Mm-hmm. You know. Got them pointy ears.
Fancy pants, basically.
But yeah, apart from that.
Yeah. I'm just asking.
I feel like I should get something damaging, but seriously, like, nothing suits my character.
I got that covered, don't worry. I got that covered.
I have a gun, it's fine.
So, as I was looking around the town, Sam, did I find a vantage point that I could see the town from?
Yeah. It's probably like a water tower.
Yeah. I don't have anywhere to communicate with everybody else. But...
Phones? We all have phones?
I guess.
Yeah, you probably all have phones. So are you climbing up this water tower, or are you just...
Yeah, I want to climb up the water tower.
Okay. You can do that, there's a ladder.
Just look across the town and everything.
Yeah, other than the... bandits you came in here and the bandits you saw on the just before you entered the town, there's not really any other sign of the bandits.
While we were coming in, like while we were driving between the camp and this base, can we say that I cast mage armor?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, I cast mage armor.
Do I see, because I have my sniper rifle, I guess, can I see where the rest of the guys are? Or being led to.
Yeah.
But, yeah.
Other guys.
Not other guys, the, yes. Zyra and...
The rest of the party.
Yeah.
You see that when I cast... Sorry. You see that when I cast Mage Armor, my whole suit has, like, a grid pattern on it.
Ooh.
Ooh, gritty.
Grid.
I like grids.
Like a red grid. Yeah, Black Tron!
But the, yeah, they say they lead you up to the northern part of town, and they say as you're kind of walking up there, you've heard about the boss, I presume.
Guys?
Oh, is that us? Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, I heard a bit about it.
I'm not speaking because I wouldn't, but come on.
Yeah.
I didn't realize I was us. I heard a bit. We don't get too much info out in the West, it seems. So if there's something I need to know about, you tell me, just to be sure.
He's a right fucking dickhole, but he's an okay guy.
Sounds like my
type. He's just a bit, you know, strict and...
Strict?
He's a very particular man.
Particular?
Uh-huh.
What's he particular about? Is there a particular thing he's particular about?
He has this vision of his head of how things should be done, you know.
Too complicated.
Too rap. Mm-hmm.
Alright, let's go meet this boss of yours.
Okay, so,
he don't mind sea guys, does he?
What did you say?
Cigars. He doesn't mind cigars, does he?
Cigars.
Cigars.
He doesn't mind seagulls, does he?
He doesn't mind seagulls.
Look, you watch any Southern movie, and if they don't say cigars, then you're watching the wrong Western.
Yeah.
Just saying.
Cigars. Yeah. I sort of turn to Zyla, who I presume is like still tapping away on his
yes.
tablet.
So, that is totally happening. I'm planning stuff, just so you know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so am I, but yeah.
Do anything, I'm shooting someone.
Yeah, just sort of turn to Zyla and so I'm just like, you're coming?
My pod down.
Yeah, I'm following you guys.
Yeah.
I'm behind you, like, walking along, tapping away, listening in with my grid clothing on.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I
so he leads you up to a,
I lead into the hillbilly. I look at him and I'm like, you figure that person right there, female or male?
I don't know. I seen his butt. He kind of looks like a woman to me.
Got that booty though, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know what you're saying.
You got that booty though.
Got that booty though.
And then I talk and I've got this ridiculously deep voice.
Never
what
mind.
What are you saying?
Never mind.
I don't know, man. That's been puzzling.
They were just found out it's just like a voice changer in the mask.
Yeah.
No one knows that is true to... voice. It's just always distorted or something.
Mm-hmm.
Are you one of them queerosexuals?
Queerosexual.
Let's go meet this Basio.
That you're led up to this kind of old manor house. But it looks like pretty much uncared for, and the windows have been boarded up with planks, they kind of take you into this house, and you see, and though it's quite beaten up outside, it looks fairly decent inside. Like, it's still got much of its old, like, furnishing. But you are led through to a room with a bunch of maps, just maps of the surrounding area. Just, like, pinned to the walls.
Are cameras a thing in this world?
Cameras?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, I suddenly take pictures of them all.
Nice.
There is a spell invisible to cameras.
Mm-hmm.
Good point. There we go then.
And there's kind of like locations.
Hold up, let me take a selfie.
It's kind of locations marked on the maps in red. Some of them with like X's through them. You presume that's the one; those are the ones that they've hit. But you see, two men arguing. They're having a rather like heated debate. One of them's just like saying like, "What if they come for me and shit like that?" And the other one's just trying to like calm him down a bit. One of them is. The one that's like saying, "What if they come for me?" is a human,
mm-hmm.
Or at least he appears so.
Does he seem to resemble a certain picture?
No.
Well,
neither of them.
Neither of them do.
Okay. Well, I guess it's time to pull out the spells then.
But yeah.
Yeah.
He's kind of. He's dressed in the human is dressed in in Kevlar body armor.
Mm-hmm.
He has a pistol at his side, and you see he's got a bunch of scars on his face. He looks like your typical kind of tough guy, you know.
Mm-hmm. I mean, he obviously doesn't sound like a hick, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
He doesn't sound like a hick at all. But the other guy is a half-orc. And he is. He's a big man. Also dressed in like leathers, and he's kind of, and he has sunglasses on.
Half-orc
with sunglasses on.
Inside.
So are we introduced to these two as like one of them as our boss?
Yeah, one of the guys you were with says, "Hey, boss, these are the fellas from out west." And he says, "Oh, so you finally joined us." Oh, good.
Oh,
God.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Good God. Tech thoughts.
It comes out as a readout on my tablet.
Do they think?
I'm just like looking at my tablet, and then I'm just detecting the thoughts of the boss guy. Surface level thoughts.
Okay.
Yeah. What it says specifically.
That guy looks like a girl.
No. What is most on its mind at the moment?
That guy looks like a girl. What the hell kind of people is he sending?
Dude, it's been on fucking Agassus's mind this whole time too. Like, bad guy or girl, never know.
These guys,
then I got some real long questioning to do with myself.
Yeah.
These guys are weird bandits, you know.
Yeah.
Because we've got a Goliath.
Are you detecting the thoughts of the other guy as well?
I use my action to shift my focus to the other guy. They can't detect this, by the way, not at the moment.
Yeah. The other guy is just like, who the fuck are these guys? like, Borg didn't mention anything about this. Yeah. About bringing guys from out west.
Okay, I'm just going to keep that running while we talk.
Mm-hmm.
I look to the orc and I say, you're the big boss himself.
That'd be me.
Well, it's good to finally meet you. Also good out of the shithole that is the west.
You're telling me I've been there myself.
Also, just as a quick recon, how many people are currently in the room bar us?
There are currently a couple of guys waiting outside, so there would be bar us about, bar you, maybe about six, including the two that were talking.
That's a nice number. Okay. And they're just regular bandit fellows.
Regular bandit fellows by the looks, yeah.
Cool.
By the way, would any of us have like silencers for weapons? Or
I
we
sent
to, like...
a text, by the way, saying I was on the water tower to Xyla.
I totally got it.
even if you had silencers, it would be.
Oh no, I'm just saying, like as a.
Ash is not the way it goes.
It'd be pretty easy to hear.
Yeah, I was just saying, like, as a sort of afterthought. Like, I'm not planning on shitting the whole place up right now.
Yeah. But
like, would my rifle and pistol have a silencer?
If you're trying to be discreet about it, then maybe.
Hey, I look up at the big boss and say, I've never caught your actual name. Everybody around here just calls you Bob. What's your name?
Name's Bork.
My name's Agassi. What's
Name's Bork.
Is that the guy who was supposed to kill? I've forgotten the guy who was supposed to kill him.
Oh, it was Larius. Larius.
Elyraes.
I looked at him. I looked at the orc and I say, "What's your friend's name?"
Yeah. Oh, you don't like to tell anybody his name.
It's him.
Ah, you can trust us. From the west. Don't get told shit out there.
Make a persuasion.
Oh, fuck yeah! I celebrate too early. But my persuasion
I have to take
is pretty good.
Surely he's, like, thinking about the dude.
Yeah. Yeah, but you focused on the other dude.
I'm just jamming between them. All like, right. I'm jumping into whoever they're talking to.
I don't know which one's the check or ability. I don't... Forget the second
the
one.
The first one.
Okay.
Yeah, the first
one. Fuck.
Let's apologize.
I ain't telling you shit.
But it seems to tell everything.
Yeah. surface thoughts. He's like... Now, why would they want to tell... Why'd they want to know about Elyraes?
Is that the guy who was supposed to kill Elyraes?
Yeah, that's him. Yeah, that's him.
Okay.
Cool.
I could sort of tell as soon as he says, now people knowing his name.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, cool. So as soon as that happens, should we just kill them now? I mean, I can do.
I don't know. You're the only one who knows.
Yeah. You could just text each other.
In the meantime, I'm just talking about, like, hey, I'm used to it. You don't want to tell me, I won't cry.
I just
want
to go on for a bit longer.
Yeah.
Well, I type away and I do text, like, it's the guy on the right or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Watch out for 10 seconds, and then give them a countdown.
Yeah.
It's the guy on the left.
I aim at the guy on the left from way back where I am.
Oh, you don't
aren't
need
we,
to do that.
We're in a building, aren't we?
Oh, yeah, you are. I'm just going to cover you guys' retreat.
Yeah. I I just
so
start
I get ready
making...
to take out the two guys at the front.
I might talk with the boss. I say, so I hear we're raiding town here soon.
Yeah, that's right.
Boys are seem pretty excited. I won a gun off of one of them in a drinking contest. You drink? You drink at all?
Of course I drink. What do you think I am?
Hey, I don't judge. I don't make assessments. You ain't drinking now? That's too bad. Too bad. Looks like you might have a couple of things for me to win around here that's worth some value.
So, like, behind the head, you see a hologram of, like, the number 3.
Yeah.
And then the number 2.
When it gets to 3, I just kind of put out my cigar and just, like, put it in my pocket and just, like, when it gets to 1, I just say, I'm real sorry about this.
Goodbye, everyone outside.
I just say,
like, I haven't said anything throughout this entire thing, and I'm just like,
yeah.
Good night. And I just hit the key.
Just as it hits 1, sorry about this.
Well, hang on, let me put them to sleep first, before you start shooting people.
With an AA-12, close range.
I mean, it's a shotgun! At close range.
I mean, I might put them all to sleep, and then you shoot a sleeping person.
Are you doing the guys outside, or are you doing the guys...
Yeah,
it goes lowest hit points first, so that's why I asked if they were bog standard bandit men.
Yeah,
they...
it'd be those guys. Is it the guys inside?
I'd probably go closest to us, radiating outwards to the bog standard bandit guys. I just want to turn them all off, basically.
Alright.
Yeah, I'm gonna take out the guys outside.
Little do they know, they have implants in their head, which put them to sleep.
Oh, crap, I should have put all this in ranged weapons. I'm smart.
Yeah, I'm gonna cast this at second level.
It's probably a fucking frequency.
But 7 hit points.
37. Oh, shit.
Send a frequency through someone's head. Just go to sleep.
Yeah, pretty much. That's how I imagine it.
Yeah.
It's like that sound that only teenagers can hear.
3 of them fall down.
Sweet. And then I just pull my gun out. I'm like, cool.
And then you would just... Are you attacking...
I attack the guy we're here to kill first.
Okay. Yeah, you just shoot him. He barely has time to react. And, you blow, like, you just shoot him in the
blow
shoulder.
His leg off.
Yeah.
Sam, the guys outside, are they close together? Like, within 5 feet of each other?
Close together?
Yeah, are they within 5 feet of each other?
There's 2 at the door, yeah.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah.
Alright. I hit them both, or I tried to hit them both. And again. I missed.
Yeah, first one, boom, dead. Second one, he reacts, ducks under the... ducks down and you miss the next shot.
Still don't know where I am. I'm like, what?
How are you shooting twice in one go?
I'm a hunter. I'm a bridge hunter. And
I see.
I have Heartbreaker, so if they're within... I think it's Heartbreaker. So
yeah.
If there's a target within 5 feet, I just shoot again. I thought it would be useful, sniper.
It is.
Mm-hmm. The range isn't that. It's 120. It's 200.
Oh, okay.
800.
Okay. I don't know how far away I am.
Probably within 200. Anyone else doing anything with your surprise round?
Yeah, I just...
They got time to bleed.
Fire my pistol.
So there's one...
Just really quickly, like, just pull out a fire holster.
So there's one bandit in here.
Oh. Just go straight for the head. Just look.
Which one? Are you attacking the bandit or just one of the...
Lewis. Is he dead or...?
No, he's not dead.
boss guy asleep?
No, he's not asleep. His lowest hit points first.
Yeah, lowest hit points.
Yeah.
So I knocked out three of the regular bandits.
Oh, okay.
So there's one bandit left, and Illyrius and...
The guy we killed is not dead.
Right. I aimed like right for his head.
Yeah, you can do that, James. Attack and then rage in surprise. I am surprised!
Better hit me.
Yeah, you hit him.
You're dead?
No, his ballistic vest takes most of the damage.
I'm for his head.
Well, he missed his head. It's moving about.
Well then.
You can't just kill someone.
Ah, you're a contracted killer and you can't even hit a headshot.
Probably can't hear that because you're like several hundred feet away, so.
Yeah.
I just realized I rolled.
James, are you attacking a bandit? Or are you attacking one of the guys? Okay, you killed one of the bandits.
I just realized I rolled max damage on my shotgun too. I'm happy.
Wait, in fact, I just remembered something. Check. Just a second, let me check.
Okay. So shots ring out. And I think we'll end there and get things started next time with an encounter.
Cool.
So, just to be sure, his leg flew off, but he's still alive?
His leg didn't fly off, no.
Oh, okay.
Also,
blasted him
in addition, also,
he's pretty badly hurt.
Sam. I should remember something, because obviously that's a surprise round, isn't it? So it would be a surprised creature.
Yeah.
That's a critical hit.
Nice.
So,
you,
Oh yeah, you're an assassin.
Shoot him in the crotch.
So not roll damage again?
Yeah, you would roll...
Yeah,
just
double damage.
2d6.
2d6, yeah. Nice.
The same damage again.
Mm-hmm.
Back to damage.
Wait.
Boom. Yeah, you shoot him in the crotch and he's not happy about that. Screams out.
Yes. Whenever.
Did he shoot him once in the crotch and then just again?
Yeah.
So I have.
The double barrel is 2d8.
Yeah.
That's
okay. Like a thing though. I have advantage on anyone that hasn't taken their turn yet.
Mm-hmm.
And
yeah.
Any hit I score that's a surprise, it's a critical hit.
You can roll your sneak attack on that as well, can't you? Because you have advantage.
Yeah, you can.
So you can roll another 2d6.
Yeah, alright then. Oh.
Oh. But that's quite a bit of damage.
Yeah, it's
but yeah, we'll resume. Next time.
Cool. I've only just used half of my magic points, so I'm feeling good.
I actually managed to do more damage than